Hello everyone, this is Be Focused with Chaitanya and I'm your host Chaitanya Degne. And today I'm going to share with you 6 things that helped me to change my life. First is pain, second is goal, my vision for life, third why I wanted all of that, and fourth is reading or listening to audiobooks, fifth stop caring about my failures, and last but not the least my attitude towards my comfort zone. So first of all, pain. What did I mean by pain? So whenever I felt angry, I just started to use it as trigger that something needs to change, and it's either my environment or the trigger that caused this pain, or 99% of the times it was me. I needed to change whether my attitude or my limiting beliefs towards this thing. Second thing was having a goal, a vision for my life. So I started writing down what I want, what kind of life do I want, what kind of job or work I will be doing in future, what kind of car, what kind of house would I be looking for living in, and it's something that I used to help to pull me in that particular direction, to help me pull into taking actions that would lead me to this vision for life. Because before this I was just going through motions. I was waking up, doing my work, attending my lectures, what I'm supposed to do, and then I don't see my friends like I'm used to do, or just going back, eating dinner and just watching couple of videos or movies and then sleep, and then again repeating this thing again and again. So I wasn't really doing anything towards my vision or goal, but once I wrote it down in my diary, it helped me to pull myself towards my goal. And most surprising thing was a 3-letter word, why. Why I needed to understand, then I just started writing down all these things, why I wanted this all. Why did I want the money? Why did I want fame? Well, I didn't want fame, but why that freedom? Yes, everyone wants it, but why? What is the reason? What is my reason? Because some people want success because they want to achieve themselves, and they want freedom because they don't want to work for anyone else. But it wasn't my case. So whenever I started writing the reasons why I wanted all that, I had the things that pushed me whenever I wasn't in state, or whenever I was doing the things which I'm supposed to do to reach this vision of my life. Fourth thing is reading. Well, think just like this. Your mind is a computer, and a computer wouldn't change its behavior or have any functions or features if you are not adding new codes to it, if you are not writing down and up till you code to it. And your mind is exactly the same. If you are running on same piece of software for your entire life, guess what, you will have the same outcomes that you are getting all over again. So what you need to do is just add in new codes. You are doing that by reading either or by listening to audiobooks. You can also change your environment, but it's more difficult to do. You can change the people you know, you can change the people you are surrounded with on a constantly basis. You can change the place where you eat, you sleep. This is more hard to accomplish right away, so reading will always be an easier option. Now the fifth thing is, when I stopped caring about losing something, that's when I started taking action. That's when I start to move myself towards my goal, instead of just being afraid and not taking actions, and guess what, I didn't get any results. And the sixth thing is, when I start changing my attitude towards different things and towards my comfort zone. Because I was doing everything in my grasp to get out of my comfort zone. Any person that would get me a bit agitated or that would trigger me, I wouldn't want to go with him or just see him. I would avoid him, any discussion or any person that would ask me the questions that I'm trying to avoid. I would avoid, but guess, they were the people, they were trying to make me a better person, and I started changing my attitude towards everything. If I was reading a book and I would say, I know all these things, I shouldn't be afraid of failing or I shouldn't be afraid of losing. I knew everything, but I wasn't living it, and I started seeing the change when I started changing my attitude and becoming more humble towards it. Just for example, if you think of publishing a book and becoming a best-selling author is an easy thing, then why don't you do it in next couple of months? Write a book and make it as a bestseller and see how easy or hard it is. Well, it's not hard, but it's not easy either. And when I start realizing that, I started becoming more humble. That's when I started valuing all the things that I'm getting. And being humble, I'm not where I am, and I should be listening to the people who light years ahead of me. And that's it. That's what really helped me in changing my life. And if you are improving in each and every aspect of these things, you will really start seeing the drastic change. So now you have listened to me, that's great. Now what you need to do is just call to action. You need to first understand that whenever you feel pain, anger, anything sort of pain, realize that it is trigger for you, that something needs to change, and it's usually either yourself or your surrounding. Second thing is, you need to write down your vision for life. What do you want to have in life? What do you want to be with? Where do you want to go? Where do you want to live? What car you want to drive? And afterwards understand why. Write down all of these things and start realizing your why. It will help you understanding your insecurities and work on them. And this will also help you to push to achieve whatever you want in your life. And the fourth thing is reading. If you are not reading at all, just define 90 minutes a week to read about something that you really like, something that interests you, not a blog or any Instagram post. Read a book or listen to an audiobook, something with a strategy that you can use right away to achieve whatever you want. Last but not the least, whenever you feel resistance, whenever you are afraid of doing something and you need to start small things on daily basis, it's not about the benefit of that particular thing that you are doing. It's about building the habits of doing new things that you are uncomfortable about. And all is about habit, it's not about the result. And if you are focused on all of these aspects, so try all of them and I'm sure you will see the results of this. You start seeing yourself change. You don't get overweight by night. It's not like yesterday I was skinny and today I'm fat. No, it's not like that. It's on what you do on a constant basis. It's the habit that you are doing. It's the habit that you are building that are causing on a long term. So don't expect quick results. Just focus on the habit, on being consistent. That's what will truly make difference on long term basis. I hope this will definitely help you and I really believe that this will definitely provide you a lot of value. So this is all for today. Thank you for listening to this podcast. This is Techno Chaitanya and I will see you soon. Till then, take care, enjoy and have a great day and stay tuned for the next episode.